My name is Ali Ture. I am a Gambian. I am a student of Rogers Foundation College of Africa.
My name is Usman. I'm from Gambia.
I am a student of Rogers Foundation College of Africa.
My name is Aisha Duba. I'm a Gambian. I'm the student of Rogers Foundation College of Africa.
My name is Maliba. I'm a Gambian.
I'm one of the students of Rogers Foundation College of Africa.
My name is Ibrahim Amjane. I'm a Gambian. I'm a student of Rogers Foundation College of Africa.
I come from a poor family. My father was poor, my mother was poor.
There was a problem that I was facing. There were sometimes I used to go to school, but they would bring me back because of school fees. I was given to my uncle that was helping me and my family. That uncle was helping me, my education, my school fees, and my school activities, and my family.
Anything I want, my uncle will help me. I was good, just trying like that. In school, up to one day, my father now come and talk to my uncle that they have one man who called Rogers, want to help me. Now they come and tell me. I tell them, no problem, I can do it. My father say yes. Until I was so poor, since I was coming, my father was thinking about me. How if I come, how will I do? They was giving me a lot of advice for me to come and learn here very well.
I was living with my mother. We have difficulties in the compound in my education with my small sister. I will go to a far school. Sometimes I can even walk, but sometimes I will take car because I will just pay small money to go. I can trek back home when the boys leave me. And I have some of my friends. They are richer than me. They have money more than me too. They will be bringing good books in the school. They will be writing. I will be just having one book for 4 subjects or 5 subjects. I'm just praying for God to give money to my parents to help me. But even when I have a problem with somebody, you just tell me you are poor, see the suit you are wearing, see the clothes you are wearing. But one day, they just called my mother and they told him that your child is going to Nigeria to learn. And my mother get happy and tell me, you are just going to Nigeria and learn.
Back to my country, I was staying with my mother, father, brothers and sisters. After many years, I lost my father at the age of 12 years old. I stayed with my mother, brothers and sisters. Life was very difficult for me. I think now, no father for me, I will not see the way of school. I was staying with my mom. My mom don't have work and I'm not going to school. I stayed for 2 years without going to school with my brothers and my sisters. Everything was very hard for me. I think nothing will not go better. But our first lady was round our house, the president was rounding all over Gambia. She went to my state and all of his, he, many less privileged children are suffering there. After he promised us, he will take us to Nigeria to learn. They called my mom. After calling my mom, they told my mom they want to bring me here to Nigeria to learn.
I am a boy who have mother and father, but my mother and father cannot afford to pay for my school fees. And life was so difficult in my country about education. Education was so hard. Sometimes I should not go to school because of money or school fee.
Back to my country. My life was difficult in my country. I don't have a good education. And I'm sitting in my home. I'm not going for school for 2 years. And my father lost his job and my mother also too lost his job. And they are helping me for me to go to school, but they can't. My father is trying his best for me to go to school, but he can't help me. Because of that, I lost my everything. I'm not going to school. I didn't have even a good uniform to wear to go to school.
And I come to this school, Rogers Foundation College of Africa. I see many things in this school. These classrooms, the library, the labs, everything are normal. Our fame hall, the football ground, everything is okay. our DG, our teachers, we have wonderful teachers, good teachers that will teach you and you will understand. If even if you don't understand, you go to them, they will try you, they will try their best for you to understand. And we have our Dini, our sister Yusi. Sister Yusi, our sister, who helped us and is the one that wants to bring Africa together. I want to thank my daddy, Rochas Okorocha, executive governor of Imo State. I want to thank him for giving me this opportunity to come to Nigeria and learn, for giving me clothes to wear, and for giving me very free education, good school. I thank him. May God bless him. May what he wants, may God give him that. May God help him. May God give him a long life so that he can help another people.
But now I thank God, my first lady, helped me to come to Nigeria to learn. And the time I come to Nigeria, I saw a man who saw me the right way. And he told me, you are not a less privileged, but you are a student of Rochas Foundation, and you will be my son. I tell him, thank you, Daddy. He said, I will give you everything you need in Rochas Foundation. And all what he said, tell me that is true. And I'm here in Rochas Foundation. I'm seeing all what he says is true. We have good facilities. As you are seeing, we have football field, basketball court, volleyball, and we have good coaches to teach. We have good classes. Good, everything is good in Rochas Foundation. 3 times you will eat food, and you have your clothes, you have everything. Even singlet they will give you. And we have good coaches. And it's not education. He bring us here. If you don't succeed through education, you can succeed through sports. Bring us here in Nigeria to learn. And he tell us hard work is success. He faced the same difficulties selling orange. But now he's a governor of Imo State, Rochas. As people know him as their governor, but I know him as my daddy. And I know he will be my daddy forever and ever.
After bringing me here, I saw the great man who is Rochas Anayo Okorocha, who brought me to Nigeria and gave me free education, free shelter, everything what I need in my life. I see now my life is getting better in my feet, and everything was very, very hard to me, but now I see now everything is getting good. He gave me free education, free food, free everything what I need. I have good teachers, good computer library, good football field, everything what I need, I'm having it. And this man brought Africa together. He decided to go every African country, pick every less privileged students, 5-5 to each country, brought him here to Nigeria to learn. I'm all with them, but now I'm no more a less privileged child because I think I'm a failure. But I can pass. A failure can pass. A best thing in this world, you be a failure before you be a pass. Before you pass without being a failure, nobody rectify you. It's wrong. Me, I be a failure, but now I see now I'm passing what I need. I'm having it. I'm having my school how I feel like to have my school. I want to thank my daddy Rochas for these opportunities he have given me. He brought Africa to one. I never know Ethiopia, Liberia, South Sudan, but now I know all those countries. I never hear this Portuguese. I don't hear Creole, but now I can speak small from each language. I have brothers and sisters here. My daddy Rochas saw me love, united, everything in this world. Life was very difficult, but now I'm very happy for my daddy Rochas.
Today I'm here to thank my daddy, Owele Rochas, who have given me the great opportunity to study in Nigeria.
And given me things like food, shelter, all are free. And giving me things where to study, like chemistry lab, classes, biology lab, physics lab.
I came into Nigeria here. I have a free shelter, free clothes, and free everything. We have a good labs. We have a computer lab. We have a chemistry, biology, and we have our good library. And we have good facilities. We have our basketball court. We have our volleyball pitch and we have
of football pitch. I want to thank Daddy Rogers who have given me this opportunity for me to come in Nigeria to learn. May God bless Daddy Rogers.
I wish, after being a doctor, I will become a great man in life so that I will help other people that are poor, give them free education, everything they want in their life.
I wish to be an ambassador in order to help the less privileged in my country and Africa.
I want to be a best hairdresser, not only Africa, but all over the world. And I decided if I grow up, I will build a foundation for a less privileged children.
As you can see, he helped us in plenty things. In my country, I can eat 2 times a day or 1 time. But now I'm eating 3 times a day. And see, the time I was coming, I was not like this. But now I'm getting grower. And I thank that God. And any day you come here, he can make us to be happy. Make us. And he can create jokes with us. Like he's not a governor. He make himself like a simple man. And he will be the man God will bless. And God have already blessed. And this foundation will continue. Even all his family abandoned this foundation, but also the first batch, 50 students, we will try to make this foundation continue. And all other African countries will help. I used to be a lawyer, and I will help the less privileged from different countries. And I will help Gambia to be developed. And I will help all the less privileged in Africa. And I will not even stop in Africa. I will go through around the world. Because of, it's not only Africa is suffering. Other countries are suffering, like Asia. Other countries are suffering. And we need to help them. Because of the knowledge my daddy gave me, Rochester.